People have been sending us pictures all night long, from flooding to trees down, along with the damage from tonight's storm. You can send us your weather pictures using the hashtag SeeItOn7, or you can check out the photos we have so far over at WKBW.com.
Now to the COVID-19 crisis, with the daily number of deaths going up once again statewide. 30 people died from coronavirus yesterday, including 5 people here in Erie County. The infection rate for the Erie County yellow zone dropped back down to 6.62%, but the Western New York region as a whole went up slightly to 5.6%. Now, most of Erie County moved into the yellow precautionary zone back on Monday. That designation means that in order for schools to continue in-person learning, that districts have to test 20% of both students and staff for COVID-19. Now, that guidance in part forced some districts to move to remote learning. Tonight, I go in depth with Michael Cornell, who is the superintendent for Hamburg Schools and the president of the Buffalo Niagara Superintendents Association. He believes districts are trying everything they can to keep in-person learning in place.
You know, I think it's the position of most superintendents in Erie County that we want to keep schools open for in-person learning for as long as it's safe and responsible to do so, because of the benefits we know exist for children when they're in school. That's really important to us. I think that's the guiding philosophy that most of us have as we approach this idea of testing kids in school. None of us really want to do it, but if that's what's asked of us to keep students in school learning in person, then that's what most superintendents in Erie County want to do.
We have heard from parents since this guidance came out last week that some parents aren't necessarily comfortable with having their child medically tested at school. What have you been hearing from parents as a superintendent there at Hamburg?
It's a mix. We haven't sent our survey out. We intend to send that survey out early next week. And I expect we're going to get the same mix that my colleagues in other districts have gotten. A couple of districts have already sent surveys out, and they're getting about 2/3 of families who are willing to have their child tested and about 1/3 who aren't. And, you know, it's perfectly understandable. And the important thing for people to know is that we're not excluding students from in-person instruction because of the choice the parent makes about whether or not to consent to their child being tested.
You are also the president of the Buffalo Niagara Superintendents Association. We have seen schools, since this guidance came out, go to fully remote learning, in part because of these new recommendations in terms of the testing. What are you hearing from other superintendents? Do you expect other schools in Western New York in this yellow zone to now have to make that switch to fully remote?
Many of our superintendents are also inclined, as we are in Hamburg, to answer the governor's call and be a part of the solution. We certainly respect the prerogative of school districts around Western New York to make the choice that befits the circumstances in their particular school district. I know many closed because they have significant staff absences, either because they tested positive or because they had to quarantine as a close contact. And every school district is going to be faced with a choice at some point.
We're not there yet, but if the numbers continue to grow, we could potentially move into the orange warning zone, when schools would have to go full remote. Are schools prepared if they have to make that switch?
I think absolutely. One of the things that I know we in Hamburg, I communicated with my community late last week to let them know if in the event we're ready to move to fully remote, we have a plan ready to roll. And we'll roll that plan out if we get the word that we are in an orange or a red and we have to move to a fully remote learning plan.
Cornell believes it'll be strong school community, students, teachers, and of course, parents, right? All working together to tackle whatever comes next in this unprecedented school year. Ashley?